Hello PHP folks, this is the assignment 5 and 6 MVC and debugging. We're gonna go right to the assignment, where again the directions have been slightly modified. What I'm suggesting we do that after we pass number 5, you skip number 6 and go straight to the first part of number 7. So, first part of number 7 says, open the index.php file in the product manager directory and add 3 new actions. The first action should display the category list page. This will fix the problem with the list category link. And if we look at that link right now, if we click on list categories, indeed it's blank. So, if we have to fix the link, the first thing we should do is, well, what does the link say and where is it going? So, what I like to do is, do a control click on the selection here and get view selection source so we can look directly at what the link is expecting. And there it is, href, you notice is a question mark with nothing in front. What does that mean? It means that the link is going to call the same program here, which is index.php, right? So it's going to call itself again with a variable called action, and it will be populated with list categories. And here's the link categories. So, and by the way, where is that code? It must be in index. However, if you look at index, which is what we're looking at here, look at the bottom of the code and that link is not there. So that can be confusing, the way PHP uses the model sometimes, because this program is really a controller program. So what happens up here is, depending on what action calls it, it will recreate its own code, such as this one. When we ask for list products, at the end is going to include a new HTML file, product list, which displays this page right here. If we look at product list right here, at the bottom of that file, you will see the link, and here it is. href, question mark, action, list categories. So this is where this code is coming from. So we are calling the same program. So let's fix this. Back to index. Well, what we need to do is add an action that will receive list categories. And this is a new code. I'm going to take this comment, move it in the next else. This is a code you will have to write. If action is list categories, then the first thing we need to do is get categories, because we're going to, I'm sure it will be necessary when we include the categories PHP, which is already given. And where does this come from? Well, this is a function, one of the functions in category DB, which is half given to us, and get categories is right here. And it first calls global DB, so we have access to the database. Then it sets up the select everything from categories in order by category ID. Give that to query, and then we go ahead and execute the query and keep it in result and return result. So back to index, result is now populating categories, and we're ready for that. Notice an echo here, based on chapter 6. It's a good idea to put that code in here the first time you run it, just so you know the program is indeed receiving action, and your action is called list categories, and it is executing this else if. So it will tell you that debug in if action equal list categories. And it will exit. There's no point going any further. You're just interested to know that your program is coming to the right place. Now that it is coming to the right place, we can include categorylist.php. And so save this, go back to the program, and if you click on that, boom, we are now getting a copy of that program. And okay, ready for the next part. Back to 6, open the model category DBP, PHP, and add a function to add a category. We will need that now. So, similar to function add product on page 169, but only one parameter. And we can wait for the delete function later. So, let's go to category DB and add the category. So, again, global DB. This is a function, by the way. It starts with the root function. It has the name of the function, and if we are passing it any data, we put it right here in this parameter list, of which there's only one. And we are passing name. That will be significant because we need to pass this function a name of a category if we're going to add it, correct? Okay, so the SQL is insert into categories. Category name is the name in the database, and the value is going to be what we have just passed it in here. Now we have content of a category to add, and we are passing it on to the value in between the single quotes. And then you execute. So this is the first function you need to do. The next one you'll have to do is delete, and that one is not any more complicated than that. Okay, back to the assignment. Number 3. Then now you can skip to 9. And 9 simply says, in the category list PHP file, write the code that lets the user add a category to the database. This code should consist of a form, and you know how it looks like, and with the add. Good, so let's go to category list. And category list. These comments are for the next part, but this is where we want to go. Add category, and as you know, we need to make a form, first of all, because that's what that is. And the form is going to call index.php, which is different from the first program you wrote 2 weeks ago. And the method is going to be post. We have an input type hidden because we need to pass the action. Now that we're going into the index file, which is designed to use several different kinds of actions, we need to specify this action. This is the name action, and we have to give it a value, and we're going to give it the value add category. And then you're ready to type the label. And as I always recommend, going as far as this is probably good enough for now, making sure that this part works, so I'm going to save it. At least we'll have something on the screen. So let's refresh this page and see if it works. Okay, so name is there, and I'm going to look at the source here. And there is our form, form action index PHP method post input type hidden name action value add category. So everything's working great so far. And then now you need to have a place to type the name of the category, and that shouldn't be too hard. You input type input name, and we're just going to give it name as the name of it, of the category. Input ID for the type submit. You don't really need an ID for this. Normally it's just type input type submit value add. This is the important part. And you're done with the form. So this is it. Save it. Refresh. And everything should work okay. Right now it's not going to work because why? Because we are now missing the part in index to receive that new action. So now we're ready for the second action in number 7. which is editing index to receive the add category flag, and then add the new category into the database and call category list PHP for the new display. So back to index, and let's see what the code looks like. And here it is. If action equals add category, then we are ready to retrieve the category name. Since we sent it with the method post, it will be here under that string name. Now we have category, and what I would do right away is echo debug with name category name. In fact, let's do that right now. And exit, because there's no point to go any further. And then I need to also move this over here. Save. Let's go to here. Keyboards. Add. Debug with name keyboards. So we're doing good so far. So then you just if everything working okay, you can just redo the comments. And and this is where we call now the function add category, which we have just made, and we're gonna pass it category name, since that is what we have just retrieved and proved it right here, that this is what it said. And then here's your new command here, header location dot means you're calling the same program, which is index.php, and action, this time the action is list categories, which we already know how to do. And as I said in the assignment, you have to make sure you cannot have an echo before the location command, otherwise it will simply not work. Good, so let's bring that down below. Save, and let's see if it works. Save it. Run it. And quietly it came back to where it is. If we list products, it will have added a third keyboard. I believe there were only two before. So that part worked. And once add category is working, follow the basic steps again. 6 to 8, this time for the delete category process. So that's it for this one. Good luck.